Very good evening, everyone. So my name is Shubham Singhania, and I'm your mentor for UGC NET Paper 1, Paper 2, Commerce and Management. So this video is going to be a very short video, but an informative video for all of you who have given your NET exams and are waiting your results. So a lot of students have been reaching out to me asking me that, sir, what should we do after NET? Should we prepare for PhD? Should we go for a teaching job? Should we go for any other options? So in this video, I'm going to tell you three probable options that you can take up after giving your UGC NET exam in whatever subject, be it your economic subject, be it your management, or be it some other subject. And then I'm also going to tell you the criteria, the parameter that you should be looking forward before choosing any of these options. So first of all, let me tell you what are the three options that you should go for. First is your teaching option. The second option is for a PhD or an MPhil. The third option is for your research assistant. Now, what are the criteria to choose this? If you believe that you are not as of now planning to go for research, you're not interested into research, and your core area of interest and passion lies in teaching, then you should look for the teaching job. Now you can either look for the private university, private colleges, or you can start registering for the ad hoc panel in whichever university you are living in, whichever university you are residing nearby. You should start registering them, and then you can start giving your interviews. Until the time you start filling the forms, in 1 or 2 months, the result for NET would be coming and you would be eligible for the interviews. The second is to go for MPhil or PhD. If you think you are ready for the research and you have started looking for the topic in your area. Now, first of all, it is important to have an area defined. For example, let's say you want to do it in HR. Now, just knowing that you want to do it in HR is not going to help you. You should also be clear that if you want to do it in HR, or be it finance, or be it in any subject, what is a specific topic that you are going forward? So let's say if you talk about HR, are you willing to go for leadership? Are you going to go for training and development, performance appraisal? So the topic should be as specific as possible. The more specific you will be, the more beneficial it will be for you to get selected in the PhD interview at any reputed institute. So that is about going for a research. Third is, you want to go into research, but you are not very aware about what research is all about, what do you have to do in MPhil and PhD, and how do you write papers and all these things. But you are interested into research. Then the third option that is there for you, available to you, is going for a research assistant. Do go and look for the website of top institutes for such as IITs and IIMs, if you are from a management as well as commerce background, or in any subject, let's say if it's economics, then you can probably look at Delhi School of Economics or your JNU and other universities. These universities keep coming up with the vacancies for research assistantship. You can go and apply for the same, and the interview would be based on your post-graduation. During the tenure of 3 months, 6 months, whatever the time period is for which the vacancy has been brought up in the notification, it will give you a broad idea of what research is all about and what you have to actually do into research. So it is rightly said that before giving any exam or before entering any profession, at least know the profession well. So this research assistantship would make you prepare for your MPhil PhD in the future course of action. So that was all that I wanted to tell you. If you find this video to be informative, do hit the like button, do subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss any update. Also, I'll keep coming up with such research enlightened videos, and will keep informing you about such important topics in future also. Till then, thank you and have a nice day. Bye-bye.